She's touching me.
Let's walk.
I don't understand.
Step this way.
Yes, this is private property.
David, this is private property.
Okay, so I'll get on the RTC property. How about that?
Trespassing.
And... and let's trespass together, guys. You're going to give me 6 feet.
You want 6 feet?
No. Back you guys off, advanced on me.
We have a trespasser who is declining to leave when requested.
I'm always fighting.
Fighting
under
who?
My weight, man.
You're fighting me? Is that a threat?
No.
You're not doing the train any service.
The right of way is about 100 feet or something, 70 feet. That's what it is.
I've kept away from any mayhem here, but you guys are creating mayhem.
Email me or something. I'll be glad to communicate the details because I have it all down.
Cops are definitely coming, Elliot. I got it all on video.
Well, I've been warned about bike riding, so I better go do that.
Yeah.
Wow. I haven't ever been accosted like that. I was standing in the exact same location with Supervisor Manu, a member of the press, and other trail organizers. Manu got on the trolley, and the reporter left. And that's when board members from Fort confronted me, completely unprovoked. Fortunately, Kerry Pico intervened and prevented things from escalating further. So it's okay for Fort to have private excursion trains on publicly owned property. And when I show up to document it, I get assaulted. These are the double standards that plague the rail trail debate. Privatizing the rail corridor for weekend trolley rides is not the solution we're looking for. Sign the Yes on Greenway petition and let your representatives know that we want a trail now and not a train in 20 years.